guy, but they are certainly trying hard not to inflame the situation. Now, whether that
Leland,
is,
what's amazing though
to do that or not, I don't know.
What's amazing is they had every indication after Saturday night that this was all happening. This happened all afternoon this afternoon. Right. The curfew is not in effect tonight.
This certainly surprises me. They burn the CVS. There's no curfew. And this is a key point. You're watching the looting going on right here. Two liquor stores, Fulton Avenue and North Avenue. We've been seeing this go on all night. Liquor stores are getting looted right here. I'm here on the street, and where we were when we first talked to you, Sean, is only about 100 yards up the street right there. And the police can all see what we see, and they're not coming down here to stop this. So it does boggle one's mind that you have this amount. This is not civil disobedience. This is violence. This is thievery. This is ruining people's livelihoods. We talked to the guy earlier who owned this Easy Mart tobacco and convenience store. That place has been long cleared out. And he said, my whole livelihood's gone. They took everything and the police have done nothing. As I get my bearings here and realize the police have now retreated in about 2 hours. The police have retreated a good 150 or 200 yards and let mayhem run wild on the streets.
Leland, let me give you an opportunity here.
Some of the residents around here are saying this is ridiculous.
Let me give you an opportunity to regroup. We're going to stay on this shot, Leland, and as you get more people from the city to talk to, we'll go back to you throughout the hour. I want to invite in first Bo Dito, former NYPD detective, Mike Myers, the New York Civil Rights Coalition. We're watching all of this. This started Saturday. We have looting and burning of buildings, rocks and boulders thrown, being thrown at police officers, and bottles and cop cars burned. The police on television retreating. Mayor Giuliani had a rule: one rock thrown, one bottle thrown, and you get those people immediately, and it ends right there. What are they thinking here?
Sean, it's very obvious that these cops are directed not to take action. We had it over here in New York.
But the people that are going to endanger here are the people, the good law-abiding citizens.
Right. We had it in New York when Big Bird de Blasio wouldn't let the cops react. Here we go again. They're told to stand back. These cops would love to go in there, and they should be allowed in there and make arrests. These people are looting. They're throwing rocks. They're hitting these cops. They're doing all these things. They're committing all this violence, and these cops are told to stand back. If you think those cops are standing fast because they're afraid, that's baloney. Order outnumbered. That's baloney.
Well, they have a curfew in place tomorrow.
Yeah, but
not
Sean,
tonight.
That's the whole point, Sean. Where is the mayor now? She puts the curfew tomorrow. You got the National Guard that came on TV before. We watched it this afternoon with these boulders hitting these cops. Why weren't they able to take action?
Wait a minute. The Baltimore mayor literally said she gave space to the rioters to destroy Mike Myers.
Well, she's getting what she wants.
You have a Baltimore mayor, whatever her name is, because I'm not going to say it, but she is the David
Stephanie Rawlings
Blake. I know what her name is, but she's the David Dinkins of Baltimore. There's a failure of leadership. There's a failure of intellect. There's a failure of just being smart in Baltimore. You have people and a police commissioner. Where's the police commissioner? Why isn't there a command structure?
Here's what I want to understand. But also, in the middle of broad daylight today, at 3 this afternoon, they had 6 hours to plan and protect the city on this night. And all of what we're watching right now could have been prevented had they used just a little bit of common sense and brought in enough manpower.
Break it up.
To break this up so that the overwhelming majority of people in the city, which are in their homes scared to death tonight, wouldn't be going through this.
But the point here is, as you can see in your video, in live reports, the ruffians have taken over. The thugs have taken over the streets.
And the
more cameras are there, they're going to be in the streets because they're being show people. Mm. These are not serious people.
This is beyond show people. They're looting and robbing.
No, I'm angry. We've got folks.
If I can beat up to you.
Andre Howard,
look me up, Mercy Hospital. I got beat 2013.
Okay, hold on, whole face kicked in. Andrew, hold on. I understand you're angry, but let me ask you this. You say you've been beat by the police.
They haven't done nothing. That is little kids acting up. They're little children. Half those children. Now there's little broke adults probably trying to get
And there you can see it. You can see the looting happening as we watch the television screen. This is a local community. People are robbing their own stores. They're robbing their own stores. The mayor came out today and said this is idiocy.
and you make us look bad.
Just one second. There's no question that's what's going on. Go ahead and just keep that shot up right now as we see everybody coming out. There you go. Just give me a second. Megan, can you still hear me?
I can hear you. And, you know, right next to you, obviously, they are looting this convenience store. The mayor came out and said these are thugs.